And the next question is actually a Twitter question. So it comes from Mark191. So he asked, in dealing with invasive species, does the city have an environmentally sustainable and safer way of approaching that in the future?
So I would say to Mark's question, it's part of a bigger context that we're working on. So the direct question on invasive species is the city actually doesn't manage invasive species. We have that on a contract with the Caribou Regional District, because invasive species don't know boundaries. And so in the past, the city has felt that the best manager of how invasive species move around in the region is the Caribou Regional District, because they have the full land base to do that on. But increasingly, the question is becoming, how do you manage invasive species? Are you managing it with a toxic response, which is causing more issues? And that's a question we're asking ourselves about our whole parks and green spaces in general. Mm-hmm. So I think the underlying question in Mark's main question is, can we move to a different way of managing our green spaces, managing what we would call weeds and invasive species in a different way? And the answer to that is absolutely yes. We've had some discussion about becoming a pesticide-free community, and there's a number of communities that have looked at that. I believe, when I was a member of the Legislative Assembly, argued as such, the province needs to set those regulations. I think it's unfair that, you know, one community is doing it, another isn't. Different rules around the province. I think it's much better to do it at a provincial level. But in the absence of that, we'll get down the path of looking at how do you manage invasive species and weeds without the use of toxins. Before we do that, though, one of the arguments I made was we need to get our own house in order. So we are actually looking, we've got a big piece in front of our finance committee where we've documented every park and green space that we have. We've looked at, all of our power, our flower beds are in there, which ones are perennial, which ones are annuals. And we're asking the question of how can we get the same goal of a beautiful greened up city. We have four times as much parks and green space per capita than any city our size anywhere in the province. So we have lots of that space. But the question is, how do we reduce water consumption? So we do water conservation measures. How do we reduce the use of herbicides and pesticides in those parks? Can we actually get rid of those altogether by changing to a different plant species? In our downtown, in our Reed Street project, we challenged the planners there to come to us with perennials that flower over the course of the season. But they're there permanently, and then if we put the beds in properly, you're minimizing the weeding, and if the irrigation system's in properly, you're minimizing the water that's okay. needed. So that'll be a set piece for us mm-hmm. to look at that. But ideally, the city of Quesnel needs to, over the next couple of years, be in a position that we have weaned ourselves off of excessive water use and the use of herbicides and pesticides, and we understand what that means, because then we would like to go to the, getting rid of the cosmetic pesticides on lawns and things like that as well.
Yeah.